Hello students, welcome to this session of Engineering Graphics and Design. Myself, Vimal Salod from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. In this session, we are going to study about modify commands of CAD. We know that CAD means computer aided designing, and there are two types of the basic commands. One type is draw commands and another type is modify commands. So in this session we will study about different types of modify commands. Modify commands are used to make some changes in the existing drawing. So first, to start with, I am taking one simple object, a rectangle. Here it is a menu bar, and from this it is modify commands. So when you click on this modify, this drop down menu will be opened. So these are the different types of the modify commands. Erase, first type is erase. All of you are very aware with that. By operating this command, any object can be erased. So next command is copy command. So let's operate this copy command. Here in command line you can see the instruction. It is necessary to follow the instruction shown in this command line. You can also give the command by typing, or you can give the command by operating this menu bar. So select the object. Here I am selecting this object, rectangle. Specify the base point. So here you have to keep this O snap switch on. So when you keep this switch on, we can specify different points accurately on the object. So I am specifying this point as the base point. Specify the second point. So where I want to create copy of this object, on that particular location I have to click. So whenever you want to create copies of this object, you have to just click by the cursor. So these are the copies of the original object. By applying single time this copy command, we can generate numbers of copies of the same object. Now next command is mirror command. By operating this mirror command, we can create mirror image of the object. Same image of the object can be created, and with the same distance with reference to mirror line. So first we select one object as reference, rectangle. Now operate this command, mirror line, modify command line. It is the mirror command. Select the object. So this object is selected. Then press enter, specify first point of the mirror line. So I am specifying here first point of the mirror line. By applying XY coordinates also, you can specify the required point on the screen. Then specify the next point or the second point. So here I am specifying the second point. Now see the instruction in command line. Erase source object, yes or no. If you want to erase the original object, then you have to enter yes, and if you don't want to erase the original object, then you have to enter no. So here I am entering the option no. For that type N and then enter. So you can see same mirror image of this original object is produced over here. Next command is offset command. Offset command is used to create the same object but with some particular distance. So let's take one circle as the reference object, and now let's operate the command from this drop down menu. specify offset distance. So it is necessary to specify the distance by which we want to create another object. So here I am taking two units for the reference. So I enter 2. Select the object to offset. So I am selecting this object. Now specify the point for side to offset. So with reference to original object, you want to produce another object inside the circle or outside the circle, that we have to specify. If you click outside, then object will be created outside. If you want to create inside of the circle, then click inside. So concentric circles can be prepared by applying this command. Next command is array command. By operating array command, we can create the same object in numbers of columns and rows arrangement. So first let's draw a small size circle as the source object. And now operate this modify command, and from modify select the array, and we are going to create rectangular array. So select the object. Object is selected. Now here you can see numbers of rows and columns are created for the same object. There are 4 columns and 3 rows. These numbers are taken by default, because in previous drawing these are the values which might be given to create this rectangular array. We can also change these numbers of columns and rows. So if you want to change the columns, then simply here type column, col, enter the numbers of columns. Now instead of 4, if I want to create 8 numbers of columns, then enter 8. So here you can see 8 numbers of the columns are produced. Likewise, we can also change the numbers of rows. Next command is move command. We can move the object anywhere on the screen where we want to move it. So let's take one object, a rectangle, and now we want to move this object somewhere on the screen. So from modify menu, select move command, select the object, specify the base point. So here I am specifying this base point. Specify the second point where we want to move this object. That particular point we have to select. So the original object is moved over here. Then next type of modify command is scale command is used to produce either enlarged size of the object or to reduce the object up to some extent. So first we take one reference object, this rectangle, and now operate this command from the modify menu, scale command, select the object, then press enter, specify the base point. So here base point I am specifying. Specify the scale factor. Here instruction is you have to see, and it is necessary to follow the instruction on this command line. Specify the scale factor. If you want to enlarge this object, then you have to specify that factor, enlarging factor. And if you want to reduce this size of the object, then you have to specify the reducing factor. So suppose I want to enlarge this object, by 2 times, so I will enter 2, then press enter. So this object is, you can see here, it is enlarged size of the object. The original object is enlarged by 2 times. We can also reduce the original size of the object. Let's see how it can be reduced. So it is a rectangle, source object, modify command, from modify menu, scale, select the object, press enter, then specify the base point. So here I am specifying base point, specify the scale factor. Now we want to reduce the original size of the object by half time, so enter 0.5. So you can see the original object is reduced by the 1/2 time than the original size by our choice. Next command is chamfer command. The chamfer command is used to produce the sharp edges on the object. So first I take this rectangle as the source object, and then we will operate the chamfer command. It is chamfer command. Select the first line you have to select. Then these are the options how chamfer can be created. So I am taking distance as the selected option. So for that, type D and then enter. Specify first chamfer distance. So I am specifying, for example, 2 unit as the chamfer distance. Specify second chamfer distance. Again I am taking the same distance, 2 unit. Specify the second line. So second line I am taking here. If you take second line over here, then chamfer will be created in between these 2 lines. Or if you take here, then chamfer will be created between these 2 lines. So I am selecting this line. So you can see this chamfer is created. Select the first line. I am selecting this line. Select the second line. Again I am selecting this second line. Second chamfer is also created. Here one point you should notice is that by applying second time command, I have not mentioned any chamfer distance, though it is created over here. So by default it was taken 2 units as the value for the chamfer, because previously it was entered 2 units for the chamfer. Next command is fillet command. If you want to create corners, rounded corners on the object, then fillet command is used. So let's take rectangle as the source object. Now apply this fillet command. Select the first object, let's select this line. Now for corners, we have to give radius. So for radius, I am typing R and then press enter. Specify the fillet radius. How much radius we want? So that amount of radius we have to enter. Suppose I enter 2 units as the radius. Select the second object. If I select here, then fillet can be produced on these 2 sides. Again I am operating the same command. Select the first object. I am selecting first object. Then I am selecting the second object over here. So again this fillet is created. Again I am operating this command. Select the first object. It is first object. Select the second object. Again select the first object. Select the second object. So this is the way how fillet can be created. these are different modify commands. Now if you want to write down the dimension, then we need to operate the drop down menu. Here you can see it is dimension. So I'm operating this menu by clicking on this. You can see there are numbers of options where we can give the dimensions. For example, I'm selecting linear dimension. So for linear dimension, specify the first extension line. So here I am specifying the first extension line. Specify the second extension line. Here is the second extension line. And you can see it is the dimension. Whatever dimension is here, that will be generated automatically. So it shows it is the dimension 10.74 units. So this is the way how dimensions can be given. Another option is, so these are different modify commands. Thank you very much for watching.